Hello everyone, and welcome to another Company Heroes 2 replay cast. My name is ATR, and today we're gonna have ourselves a 1v1 on Langreskaya. Our heroes today are going to be SturmTigerGiap, playing as the OKW forces in the red. And his opponent is going to be Korean Air Force, the third wing, playing as the British forces, the UKF, in the blue. And there you go. That's about as much as I have to say. Let's see what's going on from the beginning. We see Korean Air Force going for two infantry sections and then following it up with the Vickers machine gun. SturmTigerGiap, for his part, has gone for a Volksgrenadier squad and a Kuvelwagen. The Kuvelwagen hitting the field right now, pushing forward, and should be hitting those infantry sections in a little bit. But not much else going on. We see capping right now through the south, southwest for Korean Air Force, while Giap is capturing the northeast. And there we go. First engagement, pretty much, as the infantry section runs straight into the center. The Kuvelwagen, already set up and waiting, pins it down and forces it to retreat. Vickers machine gun from behind, getting some good shots there on the Kuvelwagen. The Kuvelwagen going to be backing off, but it is going to gonna make it out of there, so it should be fine. Sorry. Anyways, so yeah, we see on the side a Storm Pioneer squad coming up for the flank on the Vickers machine gun. Vickers machine gun repositioning itself as the Kuvelwagen pushes forward. We have the infantry section backing off and getting inside the house, making sure that it is fortified. But the Storm Pios decide to go for the cutoff as the infantry section outside of the base is going to try to displace them. Does get to force a retreat, even though they didn't take that much damage. They just didn't want to take unnecessary damage, as it was highly unlikely that they would have been able to really do much against the infantry section in the heavy cover and near the base. Infantry section does take a loss here as they cross through the open. Volksgrenadiers in front of them taking some shots. The Kuvelwagen did back off, so the infantry section is quite fine. But they are currently set up to heal friendly units, as the Vickers machine gun is behind them and getting healed up in the process. We're losing a capture point. Infantry section pushes forward as the Vickers machine gun is getting right on top of it. No, it's actually staying behind. Never mind. And the Volksgrenadiers move back. We do see wire getting laid down across the hay bales, making sure that the heavy cover is not going to be benefiting Korean Air Force in the process. And in the center, we see the Kuvelwagen catching an infantry section on the retreat. Going to take some shots at it. Small shots, not going to do too much damage, but away they go. Mines, shoe mines, getting laid down for SturmTigerGiap up in his cutoff point as Korean Air Force went for the cutoff to return the favor that Giap made in the south. And we now have Tier 1 gone down, the platoon command post for Mr. Korean Air Force, and he calls in, a Royal Engineer squad. There you go. So 210 versus 280. Sorry. Storm Pios in the center, trying to lay down some more shoe mines, get shot up a little bit there by the infantry section and the engineers, forcing them to back off a little bit and cancel the production. But not much else going on, not even music for the game, since it is quiet as whatever. Anyways, Volksgrenadiers over on the right-hand side, going to be continuing to cap. MG34 has been set up inside the house for Giap, as he has selected his doctrine, and that is the Luftwaffe ground forces doctrine. And over here on the far left-hand side, we see... Oh, cool. So Langreskaya got changed a little bit in the way that its points are distributed. The victory points have been changed in an angle. Before, they were all the way out over here, pretty much guaranteeing that each corner point was always in the possession of, you know, the player on that side of the map. So instead of the victory point being up here where it usually was, it is now down here by the intersection near the houses. So makes it easier to defend, but also easier to take. You know, it's cool little change. I like, you know, the progression. Also, the house that was here, the second check has been removed in favor of putting the point there. So that's an interesting change. Not sure what else has changed, but, you know, it's always nice to see those continuing involvement of the maps. I mean, they are direct descendants of the, you know, the Company Heroes 1 maps, but they have been continuously improved. I mean, obviously this gap was introduced as a little gap before, then it got added furthermore into a big, big gap here in the hedge, opening up the map entirely, whereas the original version of the map, it was completely closed off, so, you know, that would be one of the things. Sniper taking a shot at the Kugelwagen losing its engine in the process. Engine damage doing quite a bit there, managing to break the suppression going at the engineers. But it does not manage to take out the Kugelwagen. MG34 inside the house manages to get a pin down going on the Vickers machine gun. The Vickers machine gun will continue to shoot, but it is pretty much ineffective. Also, I've been informed the trenches do cost 50 manpower, so, you know, they're not exactly free. But it's something to keep in mind. And infantry section and Volkskrins are engaging over here on the left-hand side. The Volkskrins are in heavy cover, so they'll win against the medium cover. Not to mention that there's two there. Sniper will be brought into the mix, but you see. Royal Engineer Regiment has been selected for Korean Air Force, so we'll see how well he utilizes that. For now, though, he is building a Bofors 40mm emplacement right there in the center of the map. A little bit covered there by the hedge. However, it is still in a very powerful position, and with a trench in front of it, it's, you know, a little bit more secured. Back at base, we do see the Schwerpanzer headquarters going down for SturmTigerGiap out in the open, in a position where previously it would have defended the victory point, but considering where it is now, it's not going to do as much. Could have essentially been moved around over here so that it had, you know, cover up the fuel and the victory point. Maybe be covered behind the house, although putting your building in front of a house is very risky, as it tends to allow your enemy to pop in if you're, you know, if you're forced out of the building. And then it makes it a pain in the ass, but a Schwerpanzer headquarters isn't that big a deal. It'll just shoot up everything inside and kill them. So at this point, I mean, bring it out here in the front. I mean, it does cover the cutoff point, which is nice. But, you know, that's about it. A little bit of a sector in the center, but yeah, not too much. Of course, the battlegroup headquarters has already gone down, and we see the infantry support gun on the field for Giap. He does have two MG34s on the field as well. But the trench is just getting blasted here by the infantry support gun, and it'll probably won't be long for this world. Ready to go. Cool wagon, forcing the engineers to hit the dirt and crawl their way out of the engagement. We do have Brenz getting purchased, or picked up, I guess is more accurate, for the infantry section. The other infantry section is just out on the field, sitting around. Stand fast, burn emplacements. The British emplacements will automatically repair while active. Not exactly sure why he popped that. It is only 50 munitions, so it's not too much. But I'm not sure if Korean Air Force was expecting this one to get. I mean, I guess simply because he's taking indirect fire that he can't actually prevent right now from the weapon. I guess that's kind of why he wants that. Means that he doesn't need to actually brace the structure and keeps it alive without having the engineers around. So, yeah, I mean, I guess that's a good option. So, sniper and infantry sections pushing the Volksgrenadiers on the far left-hand side away. They were going for the fuel, but they did not manage to cap it. Center map, that structure has been braced. Although, it's still repairing. I thought it was when it was active, I guess. It's not active. And here we go, SimCity starting off. The 3-inch mortar emplacement is going to be going down behind the Bofors, covered behind the house, so it's going to be kind of cool. And the sniper on the field, 7 kills so far, going to be running into some storm piles, and the storm piles explode. Infantry section with their Bren should be able to hold off that storm pile squad, as it does have a sweeper. They can, of course, disengage the sweeper to get another rifle, which they probably should do, but we'll see. And the mortar emplacement has been finished. Mortar emplacement will now be returning fire on the... No, it's actually shooting at the storm piles. Ooh, storm piles managing to dodge the hit. Sniper taking some more shots and manages to bring it down to one man. But we do have the infantry support guns now, 2 in total, online for Giap. Volksgrenadiers do have Shreks. They're going to get some shots off on the Bofors, but the Bofors is just going to wreck them if they don't get the hell out of there. Oh, that is not a good idea. Down to 1. Barely makes it out. Also, if you want to get the suppressive barrage, remember you have to put a unit inside, and that gives the Bulwarks the ability to return fire. For now, it's going to be braced, making sure that it withstands the amount of punishment that it's going to take right now. Mortar emplacements are returning fire on the infantry support guns, so the infantry support guns are going to be having to reposition themselves. But with the structures braced and the standfast ability, it's going to be very difficult, outside of a big... Oh, that was painful! That Royal Engineer squad just got completely wrecked. Grenade going off in their face, and they all go up in a plume of smoke. But, you know, doesn't matter too much. Infantry section trying to hold as we continue to hear the barrages going. Bulwark's machine gun, or Bulwark's emplacement, really, not a machine gun. Still taking some damage. It's still braced. It, can you cancel the brace, or does it have to be braced? Like, for example, here it cannot actually shoot at the storm piles because it's braced, but you can cancel it. I guess you can't cancel it. So, yeah, I guess you have to decide when you want to toggle that. Oof! Storm pile squad gets annihilated by the Bulwarks. You don't really want to be near the Bulwarks at all. Jeez. So friggin' strong. A lot stronger than the original one. Vickers machine gun and infantry sections moving back from the left-hand side as we have an MG-34 and even Fallschirmjägers on the field for Giap moving around in this direction. Nothing heavier, though. The infantry support guns are moving back out as they got reinforced and healed up. And the structures are still pretty good. We have another Royal Engineer squad online. Of course, needs to keep at least one of those on the field to be able to repair. And this trench in the center will be going down relatively soon. One more hit should do it, actually. Boom, there it goes. Get destroyed. The squad gets popped outside. But this squad actually has Piat equipped. I'm assuming only one, right? Yeah. Oof. Grenade hitting that Vickers machine gun. Bulk's Grenadiers retreating. And the infantry section popping its healing as it's free. You know, it just has a cooldown, so there's really no reason not to be utilizing it as often as you can. Because the cool thing about it is it also heals the squad itself. You know, it's not just healing for everybody else. So again, the Bulwark is in the center getting braced as the mortar behind it is just continuously doing what it does. Infantry support guns continue to get targeted. Not hitting too much, though. Volks Grenadiers behind. We have the Royal Engineers now equipped with Brens. As the infantry support guns are just continually peppering the structures, which is the natural counter to to SimCity, right? Indirect fire, because it's a stationary target, so makes sense. Boom! Piat trying to get some hits on those Fallschirmjägers. Fallschirmjägers currently in heavy cover as they have captured the fuel. Piat not hitting the sandbag itself, though, so it's not actually taking any damage, which is interesting, but, you know, it's fine, I guess.
Emplacements are ready to stand fast.
And we see that the mortar has taken quite a beating as both of the infantry support guns continue to pepper in here with damage. It has been forced to brace itself, both structures currently braced. They are currently getting repaired as the munitions keep getting dumped into that. So it allows the buildings to stay there and is basically forcing Giap to focus on that. But he now has a Jagdpanzer on the field, which will tremendously improve the amount of firepower that can go down onto the structures and quickly bring them to waste. However, there is of course a 6-pounder 80 gun on the field. Four Korean Air Force ready and waiting for a vehicle to show its face, and with both of the indirect fires, you know, focusing on the structures. Well, I mean, there you go. Manages to brace it at the last second. Over on the right-hand side, we see a flanking attack here as the Vickers machine gun gets itself right in front of everything. Engineer squad forced to retreat. Infantry section is going to be holding the line here with the Vickers from afar. And the AT gun sets itself up right in front to be able to shoot at the Yak Panzer. The Yak Panzer are going to be taking a shot to the face. Boom, there it goes. Yak Panzer are going to be forced to back off and won't be able to continue the engagement, but it's fine, you know, doesn't really affect it too much. Back at base, we do see that the company command post has been acquired, and from that we are getting a Centaur AA Mark II cruiser tank, so, you know, an anti-air, anti-infantry tank, basically. It's an interesting choice, considering that a Yak Panzer is on the field, the Yak Panzer can easily kill it. There is only one AT gun, so it's not entirely well defended, so we'll see how it works out. The mortars are back online, as the buildings continue to get repaired. And on the right-hand side, the Vickers has been displaced, but it is replaced by a infantry section with a Bren LMG. Behind it, it does have the support of a engineer squad with another LMG, but it's not doing too much, and the Vickers has been moved over to the right-hand side to capture the fuel. Over on the far left-hand side, the infantry section with the Piat. Oh, takes a nasty shot there by the Yak Panzer as it actually hits something. And the Yak Panzer moving itself up to try to get some shots on the mortar, it looks like. Mortar continue to get some shots off going. The Bullforce is going to be able to turn its sights on the Yak Panzer. The Yak Panzer will be able to withstand that quite effectively. It's going to take damage, but very small amounts of damage, especially through the frontal armor. But it cannot hope to withstand that amount of punishment, you know, for a long time. I mean, the Bullforce. But with the AT gun there for support, takes a shot there at the Yak Panzer. Yak Panzer down to about 25% strength at best, so now it suffers. And the Centaur anti-air Mark II cruiser is now on the field, getting some good damage in there and forcing the retreat of the squads on the right. So the right-hand side flank has been opened. The point, like I said here, is not being covered by the Schwerpanzer headquarters, so Mr. Korean Air Force is able to... pretty much capture that without any, you know, any problems. And on the left-hand side, we see Volksgrenadiers retreating as they decap the fuel, but the mortars were angry at them for doing that. Centaur moving up behind its structures. The structure's continuously getting repaired here as the stand-fast ability continues to be utilized. Proving actually pretty strong here. It is a big munitions dump. It's 50 munitions very often, you know, used very often, but at the same time, it is it's proving worthwhile here. So far, Giap and his weapons have really not done much. I mean, the infantry support guns continuously barrage that, trying to get some damage in there, but they're not actually doing too much, as they, you know, they haven't been able to take down a structure. And focusing on the structure means they're not focusing on the infantry or anything else. We do have a Lux on the field for Giap, so that will help out quite significantly. Pretty sure this tank can't really do anything against it, as cool as it looks. And the structures here are probably going to be forced to brace themselves. Giap throwing in some smiley faces saying about this game. I think he's enjoying this kind of game. And victory points are 271 for Giap and 466 for Korean Air Force. So Korean Air Force has done a great job at keeping the points, which is natural because of his emplacements. I mean, with the emplacement here, he can easily defend the center point, and these emplacements being here means that the back emplacement is all, I mean, the back victory point is also defended. You know, it's a little bit more vulnerable, but it is, you know, it gives him essentially defender's advantage, even if he can't reinforce, you know, has a lot of stuff nearby. So the emplacements here for Korean Air Force have taken quite a bit of punishment now. They need, he needs to probably pop those repairs relatively soon. Centaur pushing up to the north, trying to get some kills and some hits in there, but manages to only get itself beaten up. And we see once again the standfast getting popped, and the buildings will be repairing for essentially 90 seconds, so... That's actually pretty good. I mean, I don't know exactly what the rate of repair is, like, compared to a engineer squad doing that. But, you know, it's something to, it's something to keep in mind that, you know, you pop it, it's 50 munitions, of course, but it is 90 seconds worth of repair to all the buildings. And for example, here, you're maximizing effectiveness because both buildings are actually getting repaired. You're dropping a third one of some sort, you know, it just increases threefold or onefold. I don't know. Anyways, more trenches getting laid down in the center of the map there for Mr. Korean Air Force. The trench does get destroyed there as the Volksgrenadiers were targeting it as it got built, so it looks like they managed to destroy it before finishing the build, which, unless Korean Air Force canceled it, means we lost, you know, the manpower. So the anti-air truck coming on top, getting a lot of damage there on that MG-34. MG-34 goes down very quickly. The Centaur could actually target the weapon, although I'm not sure how effective it is at actually damaging it. Jagdpanzer taking a shot through the hedge, attacking ground, manages to miss the Centaur. And the Centaur makes it out of there as it backs off, but they managed to score a kill there. Bicker's machine gun going to be pushing up, trying to prevent the capturing of that MG-34. And we saw that StormTigerGiap was building something, but decided to cancel it instead. Instead, though, he is going to be building the Mechanized Regiment headquarters. And I can only assume the reason he's doing that is because he's going to be wanting to go for the King Tiger. Does have about half the way of the fuel requirements, so it'll take him a while to get there, but... No, wait, that's Giap. Never mind, he doesn't really have that much. Interesting. So, big push here at the center. Two AT guns on the field for Korean Air Force, doing a lot of damage there. The Lux being forced to back off. The MG Vickers machine gun was forced to retreat. We do have sappers and infantry section with a Pia nearby, so there's still a lot of anti-tank potential. And of course, with the Centaur, there's a lot of anti-infantry, so it's a big push, a big force. We see that the Royal Engineers have been transformed into heavy engineers, which gives him a Vickers LMG. And you can see that guy right there has it. Follow them. There you go. You can see that guy right there. It's the one with the disc on top. Kind of like a DP light machine gun. And yeah, what else does it give them? Allowing them to construct buildings and repair faster, but limiting their mobility in combat. They also become, they repair and construct faster. Oh, cool. So, yeah, it increases their repairability, so it makes it so that both buildings and everything else, you know. So, yeah, that's actually a very cool one. We're using a capture point. And I think we're probably going to see the AVRE later on, although... Fuel-wise, we see that Korean Air Force is actually building himself a Churchill infantry tank. We saw the Churchill previously, and they were quite beastly. It's a very heavy tank, and it's able to withstand a lot of punishment. It's also pretty good at fighting. I mean, you know, it's, you know, probably not the best, you know, at what it does, but it's pretty tough regardless, so it's actually able to stay in there and do a lot. Volksgrenadiers inside the house taking a lot of punishment there to the Centaur. The Centaur's just sitting there in front of everything, not going to take too much damage. We do have a Puma on the field here. The Puma could potentially take a lot of damage here to the Centaur, but the Centaur is not going to stick around to find out. The Puma is going to try to push forward here, engaging the engineers and everything else. The Centaur backing off, and we see flanking shots here by the engineers as they get run down here by the Puma. Puma now getting right on top of that Centaur, going to be getting itself quickly eliminated. Oh, it actually manages to pop and kill the Centaur. Very cool strike here, as the Jagdpanzer was also nearby to help, I guess, and the Lux behind. So Giap doing a big strike here and killing that Centaur. Korean Air Force losing a little bit of momentum there. Engineers being forced to retreat. Left hand side, we see the Vickers machine gun getting engaged here by Fallschirmjägers, but the Fallschirmjägers forced to back off. Storm Pyos coming on top of the emplacements, but the emplacements still getting reinforced. And we do have, of course, the Churchill on the field for Korean Air Force. So the Churchill could actually do a lot of damage here. Although the vehicles are now out of the field and the Jagdpanzer is nice and strong. So I don't think the Churchill is going to do too much. At least not right now. It's... has potential. Storm Pyo is going to be forced to retreat here as the Bullforce has it targeted down. Bullforce is going to be forced to turn itself around and engage everything else, so the Storm Pyos looks like they're barely going to make it out of there. Bullforce is taking massive punishment here, gets braced for damage, and manages to keep itself alive. The The ability does have a 20 second cooldown here as the Churchill moves up, getting some shots in there, and the AT gun's providing a lot of support. Yak Panther takes a lot of punishment down to about 30% strength and needs the GTFO. AT gun's pushing up, trying to finish the kill there as the infantry support guns are also getting some shots at the AT guns. The mortar behind it has gotten better in C3. 10 kills, but a lot of damage has been acquired. Creeping barrage, or creeping smoke barrage. Time between barrages and better prepare emplacements into a stronger defensive position. Not sure what it means. Probably more health or something like that. If you know what it means, you know, let me know. And, yeah. So the Churchill and the AT gun's managing to do a lot here. Royal Engineer is going to be pushing again to the right-hand side. Victory points 142 for Giap. Still 466 for Korean Air Force. So, again, he is in great shape in that regard. How much does this need? 140 fuel. He has about half of that, less, almost half now. So we'll see what he ends up doing. MG-34 in the center. Oh, the Bofors did end up going down. Let me write that down as I do not look at anything important. I also never caught the death of the sniper, so I need to go back and look at that. We probably saw it already anyways. And we'll see when the Wolfwaters ended up dying. So we see an airborne assault right on top of everything as they go in and strike and then drop a Fallschirmjäger squad on top of everything. The Churchill taking a lot of punishment here as the Puma gets right on top of it. The Puma popping its smoke, trying to break line of sight, but the Churchill has it in its sights. Oh, it misses its shot. We see another Bofors going down, getting a good hit there, and down goes the Puma. We see the Yak Panther coming up, trying to finish off the engagement against the Churchill, but the Churchill has taken some damage and loses its engine. The Bofors getting a lot of damage here on the side of the Yak Panther. The Yak Panther manages to destroy the main gun of the Churchill, but the Churchill stays alive as it was sitting in front of two AT guns and a Bofors. The Bofors now back online will be defending the center point as the Vickers machine gun is just getting annihilated here. Oof. Infantry support guns doing a lot of damage here. Infantry support guns have gotten better in C3 and better in C2. Again, very easy to get veteran C since they're continuously hitting structures, so the kill count is not important. And a brand new LMG gets selected there, or picked up there for these Royal Engineers. So the Churchill needs to get quickly repaired here. Okay, yeah. I was like, what's doing that? Yeah, so you get the ability, the vehicle crew repairs. So they will pop a smoke barrage while they repair themselves, so that's also why it's going so quickly. So the Lux coming over on the left-hand side, trying to engage the mortar. The mortar itself bracing itself for damage as it's, you know, taking punishment from the Lux and the infantry support guns. AT guns still there on the field. Only one right here. Where's the other one? Ah, there it is. And we see the engineers pushing forward with their Brents. Does this squad actually have two Brents? Oh no, it has the Brent LMG and two normal Brents. Is it a Brent LMG? No, Vickers LMG and two Brents. Wow, nice. Fallschirmjägers over on the left-hand side. A lot of veterans on those. There's veteran C4. We see the Vickers machine gun getting eliminated by them very quickly, but the Churchill is back online. He's going to be taking some shots. Could potentially push forward and do damage just, you know, by crushing them if he wanted to, although probably not going to hit them. Engineer squad getting eliminated here as it just stands in front of a Fallschirmjäger squad. But the Vickers machine gun was recovered. The LMG gets dropped onto the field. Well, that's up right, actually. I mean, it's still an LMG, but yeah. I was thinking of the Vickers LMG. And the sappers on the right moving around. So victory point 116 left for Giap. As we see the Lux moving into the center. Structure has been braced here. Structure getting debraced. Takes a shot and eliminates that squad inside the house very quickly. Wow, that was painful. And now focusing on the Lux. The Lux takes a shot. Oh, takes a shot from all directions and down it goes. And with that, we get a sync error detected as Giap just throws in the towel, unable to pierce through the defensive capabilities of the British. So that was pretty cool. That was a pretty cool example of, you know, SimCity-ish. So anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed the game. If you have any positive or negative remarks, go ahead and leave them in the comment section below. If you have any replays you want to send me, go ahead and send them to the email that I will put in the description. But otherwise, I hope you guys have a great day. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.